An Australian rover is heading to the moon on board a future NASA mission, a new agreement between the federal government and the Australian Space Agency. Joining us live is the deputy head of the Australian Space Agency, Anthony Murfett. Anthony, appreciate your time. Tell us a bit more about this rover. How will it get to the moon? What's it looking for? What are you hoping it'll find on the moon?
It's a terribly exciting day today. We are announcing that the Australian Space Agency is partnering with NASA to send a small Australian-made rover to the moon, and it's about 20 kilos in size. What's exciting is that we're leveraging this great experience that we have in areas like our resources sector that automate those big yellow trucks. What we're showing with this mission is that we're going to translate that capability and control a rover on the surface of the moon. Now, importantly, what will it do there? What we want it to do is to actually pick up some of the lunar soil, or what we call regolith, and it will transfer it to a NASA facility who will then try and extract a form of oxygen. And being able to identify and extract oxygen is extremely important, because what we want to be able to do is use oxygen either for fuel or, importantly, when we put humans on the surface of the moon again, there's an opportunity to use that as a breathing source. And I think as we do that, how does it get there? Well, if this rover meets a range of requirements, NASA is given the opportunity for NASA to send that rover to the moon for us. And I think this is what's really exciting. We've been building momentum in the Australian space sector for the last 3 years, and now NASA has seen what Australia can do, and we can put that technology on the surface of the moon, joining side by side by NASA.
So it is pretty compact. As you said, it has to weigh less than 20 kilograms. I think that's about the weight of my six-year-old, so pretty small. And all of it's meant to happen in the next 5 years. Are you confident that we do actually have the robotics technological know-how to make this happen in Australia? I mean, who's actually going to be responsible for building the rover? How many jobs could this create here?
Yeah, so great question. So what we're looking to do, there's the broader government's $150 million Moon to Mars program. And we embarked on a mission with NASA, and a key component is what we call the Trailblazer program. And it's $50 million, and we'll open this program later this year, and we're going to encourage businesses and research consortia to come together and show us that Aussie ingenuity and how we can create this rover and automate it. And I think what I'd reinforce, yes, the rover is small, but it's the capability to control that technology on the surface of the moon, which will show that Australia can integrate with NASA as it looks at activities on the moon. So where do we think they're coming from? Well, we know our mining sector. Our mining sector has those big yellow trucks. They control the drills from afar. And if we look at the Pilbara, they control some of those trucks and drills 1,600 kilometres away. So we know we already can work in very harsh environments at distance. And they're similar to what we want to do on Mars, but of course we're going to go to the moon first. So as part of that, what it does mean is that we can transfer that technology from that sector and bring it into the space sector. And what we want to highlight again is there's this massive transformation of the space sector. It is cheaper, it is getting smaller. We've talked about the 20 kilo rover. And what's exciting is now that we're going to transfer from other technologies and other sectors and put this on the surface of the moon.
Anthony, what is the overwhelming view among the space community about the ability for the moon to sustain human life? I mean, you're looking at doing this in the next 5 years, having this rover on there, but what sort of time frame are we looking to even think about that seriously?
Yeah, so it's a very serious proposition. NASA is working with a range of international partners, and we've been working with them very closely to identify the element that we can absolutely do. And because we've got that technology in areas like the mining sector, that they know that we can transfer that technology and support their missions in the next 5 years. When we look at the broader sector, what we want to highlight is this is only one of our programs that we're supporting. Yes, we're putting a rover on the surface of the moon, but there are other opportunities for our Australian space sector. Areas like Earth observation and taking those images from space and understanding drought. How do we help agriculture so they can manage water? And how do we support bushfire? That's an increasingly important area. So while we're doing the rover today, we're working at other opportunities that the sector can support. And I think this is really key for the future of Australia, because space is becoming really important to our everyday lives. We use GPS every day. We use these Earth observations for our weather. Like weather forecasting, we get 4 days from the use of satellite data rather than 1 day if we didn't have satellites. So these are the opportunities that there, and with a sector forecast to be $1 trillion by 2040, Australia's coming to the table, and we've got a range of exciting areas we can contribute.